Aquí Richard Steele ahora para las últimas instrucciones.
Yes, look, both fighters in dressing room, brushing again, obey my commands at all times, shake hands, good luck.
Bueno, y todo listo ya para dar inicio a nuestro primer combate de la noche en boxeo Telemundo Tecate. Pelea a 10 asaltos en la división de las 118 libras, aunque Ricardo, ambos estuvieron 2 libras por debajo del límite, ambos pesaron 116.
El chilango Spiti ha llegado a esta pelea logrando sus últimas 5 victorias, 5 de sus últimas 6 las ha ganado por la vía del sueño, solamente 3 de sus oponentes se han ido a la distancia, un récord hasta el momento invicto, 9 victorias, 0 derrotas, con 6 knockouts.
El chilango Spitia con pantalón blanco. Es su oponente. Dinamita Muñoz con pantalón negro.
Dinamita Muñoz con un poco más de experiencia. El chilango Spitia, 16 peleas como profesional. Él comenzó sus primeras 8 peleas ganando por la vía del sueño. Un boxeador que está haciendo su debut profesional en los Estados Unidos. Y por supuesto René quiere comenzar con el pie derecho.
Y una buena izquierda, luego con la derecha y ahora está castigando contra las cuerdas, Dinamita Muñoz, al invicto chilango Spitia, buena izquierda de Muñoz a la cara de Spitia.
René, el chilango nunca se esperó de que Dinamita comenzara a explotar tan temprano en esta pelea, en el primer round, apenas en los primeros segundos.
De los 10 knockouts, que tuvo buena derecha en corto ahora de Spitia. Decíamos que de los 10 knockouts que tiene Muñoz, el del pantalón negro, buena derecha de Spitia que lastima a Muñoz. Lo frenó en seco y va.
Un golpe realmente en el plexo solar, si está saliendo del cuadrilátero, no se va a levantar, René. Un golpe de chilango Spitia realmente en el plexo solar, le quitó el aire por completo a Fausto Dinamita Muñoz. Ahí la está viendo la doctora del cuadrilátero para ver si está bien. Impresionante el knockout, René. Quedó tendido aquí en la esquina donde estamos transmitiendo en boxeo Telemundo Tecate.
Y por poco cae fuera del cuadrilátero. Dinamita Muñoz, ahí lo están atendiendo.
René, es que fue el tanto el dolor que estaba sintiendo Dinamita Muñoz que se tuvo que casi casi arrastrar a la esquina neutral rodando. Por poco, como tú estabas comentando, se cae del cuadrilátero. Un golpe durísimo al plexo solar. Ahorita que lo vean, amigos, en la repetición. Ahí está el campeón en el primer asalto. Francisco Chilango Espita. Vamos a la repetición.
En el momento en el que estaba conectando también, con gran efectividad, Dinamita Muñoz.
René, lo que pasa primero fue un golpe en la garganta que le cierra momentáneamente el tracto de la garganta, no le permite respirar y después vendría el golpe en el plexo solar, realmente quitándole toda la respiración, todo el aire que le quedaba.
Ese tremendo gancho de izquierda al cuerpo por parte de Spitia. Vamos a ver otro ángulo. Ahí llegaba a la derecha del chilango, lastimaba a Dinamita Muñoz. Y ahora vean ahora a continuación el gancho de izquierda. Ahí está. Potentísimo, la décima victoria en forma consecutiva que logra el chilango Spitia. 7 han sido por la vía del knockout.
Se veía la desesperación ahí por parte de Fausto Muñoz. En el momento que le pegan en la garganta de René, tenía que haber puesto una rodilla en el suelo para poderse recuperar, que le dieran la cuenta de protección, la cuenta de 8 y poder seguir peleando. Pero no, él siguió tirando golpes y después recibió el golpe en el plexo solar.
Bueno, y para el anuncio oficial, aquí está Dani Valdivia.
Por nocaut en 1 minuto, 32 segundos del primer asalto. The winner by a knockout in 1 minute, 32 seconds of the first round. Still undefeated, Francisco El Chilango Spitia.
Ahí está este joven de 22 años de edad de Ciudad de San México. 10-0, con 7 knockouts. Es ahora su récord. Amigos, hacemos una pausa y enseguida regresamos con el combate en los pesos welters entre el invicto Raúl Franco y Gustavo Soto. A continuación, en boxeo, Telemundo Tecate.
main event is Frank Garza.
Gapos abajo de aquí son golpes malos, y golpes aquí, abajo de aquí son golpes malos.
Obviously establishing the belt line for those of you who do not understand Spanish. And Eric Morrell, ranked number 3 by the WBA, IBF, and number 5 of the WBC. The rules for tonight, unified rules, no 3 knockdown rule, no standing 8 count. Fighter cannot be saved by the bell in any round, only the referee can stop it. Accidental cuts, they'll go to the scorecards after 4 rounds are complete. Frank Garza signals the timekeeper. We are underway in this 12-rounder. Morrell owns one of the minor titles, super flyweight, so that is why we have a 12-rounder for you here in the main event. Morrell, though, saying that Mark Too Sharp Johnson, who we will see next week here on Friday Night Fights on the Deuce, is his objective, says it will happen. You see the knockout ratio, 6 first-round knockouts for Morrell, 9 in the first 2 rounds, 8 for Espedia in the first 2 rounds.
Morrell likes to use his leg, which is very evident right here. He's a sharpshooter. He doesn't waste much. Sometimes, maybe, doesn't do quite enough offensively. Some people might think later down the road with top guys, he can be out-hustled a little bit. But I think he's a real good prospect. Reminds me of Wilfredo Rivera, also from Puerto Rico, who fought Pernell Whitaker twice in 2 close decisions for the title. Of course, was later knocked out by Oscar De La Hoya.
Great counter shot by Morrell, and Espetia is down here in round 1.
Yeah, good counter left hook.
He's been knocked out once in his career, July 18th of last year, Leonardo Gutierrez.
Real sharpshooter, Morrell. Now he's stepping to the side, really trying to find spots. He probably should go to the body. He's got those long arms. He likes to fight at a certain distance. He's not really an inside fighter, Morrell, but he's real dangerous at that distance. He has quick hands, good eyes, good timing. Well, he takes that little step back.
The right hand hurt Espetia. Plenty of time still here in the first round.
He probably helped himself a little bit, Morrell, if he went to the body. The body would freeze the head movement a little bit of Espetia. Usually guys that go, oh, that's that right hand counter. First time left hook, that time right hand.
And I don't know if Espetia is going to get up. Swelling already around the left eye, the mouthpiece hanging out of the mouth. Frank Garza has stopped this thing here in round number 1 with 45 seconds remaining. And Morrell making sure that Espetia is okay. But 23-year-old Eric Morrell is now 22-0, 16 stoppages as the ringside position attends to Francisco Espetia.
Real good prospect, Morrell, as we were talking about. Real sharpshooter. Doesn't waste much, but he's very accurate with what he throws. He showed he can do it with both hands, left hook and right hand.
Well, the fight out there in the super flyweight by the end of the year will be Morrell and Mark Johnson, you would think.
Because, I'd like to see it.
Yeah, Morrell has the Olympian name, even though he did not win a medal in the Atlanta Olympics. He was quite young at the time, just 19 years of age, but 2:14 of round number 1, Eric Morrell comes out and stops a guy who had only been knocked out once in his career, albeit though December of last year. And take a look at the first knockdown by Eric Morrell. And Teddy, I guess it was a good left hand on the butt.
Yeah, nice left hook counter. He changes distance nice, but he's ready to punch. And right there, he makes the punch miss, throws that left hook. Just the way you draw it up. Beautiful. Slip the right hand through the left hook. Now he shows you can punch with the other hand, too, the right. Right here, you can see he takes a step back, but he sets himself down, fills the spot with that right hand.
Landed 15 of 42 power shots through the 2 minutes and 14 seconds of the fight.
That's one of the big mistakes of throwing wide punches. Espetia was throwing wide punches, and of course, Morrell had an opening right in between that. And there it is, right in between the left hook. Just the way you draw it up.
Well, you heard Eric say he'd like to join Floyd Mayweather, David Reed, and Fernando Vargas as a world champion, part of that 1996 Olympic team, and he is well on his way to at least earning a title shot, ranked in the top 5 in the 3 major organizations. 2:14 of round number 1. Eric Morrell in a very, very impressive effort, taking out Francisco Espetia.
Number one in
well,
the
we
world.
Saw another good Larry's prospect, as Max mentioned earlier. Zab Judah, very impressive in a first-round stoppage of David Sample. And now Eric Morrell gets a stoppage of his own. We check in with Brian and Max.